Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. Happy Planaholic here, and I am so excited because I am able to do a Chic Sparrow leather comparison. Dun, 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 dun. That's my awesome, you know, exciting music for you. I always get complaints about how loud my music is, so I kind of decided to stop doing some. So we'll just do, you know, fancy hand intro anyway. So what I've got here is a Creme and Darcy and an Outlander. I believe they're some, I think they're some of the more popular Chic Sparrow leathers. There obviously are more leathers than just these three that Chic Sparrow has. However, I have seen a lot of people that have these, and I see comparisons most often about these guys. So I wanted to do one for you and just give you some pros and cons of each. And yeah, so let's get started. The first one I'll go from thickest to thinnest. This one is a personal size. They're all actually personal size, mine. And this is a Creme Brulee, no, I'm sorry, a Creme chocolate. I don't remember if it's dark chocolate or something like that, but it's at least a chocolate, so yeah. This leather is very thick. I'll just show you there really quickly. It's a super thick leather. I asked for one that has texture, but not necessarily that's completely pebbled. And so that's what they gave me. They gave me this, you know, pretty texture here that transitions into this softer leather. And then it's got some texture over here still. And so that's super nice. They did a really good job. I mean, I love this. I love how interesting it is on the back. This has a riveted pen loop, which is my favorite kind, because it is much more, I want to say, versatile. I can fit my coletto in there relatively easily, whereas with a stitched pen loop, I feel like I can't do that as well. So that's just something to think about. Inside here, as I said, four elastics, and then the feeling that you get inside on this leather is super soft. It's just like so like suede. You can kind of see how it makes those different, you know, darker and lighter depending on how you rub it. So that's something that I really like because it's just soft all around. It's soft inside. This discoloration here is from this pebbling that they did. I couldn't tell you how they did it or why it's a different color inside because of it. This section is also floppier. So, you know, just so you know, that's not for me. That's how it came. And I don't care personally because I just am not that picky, honestly. I love the leather nonetheless. You know, who cares if it's a different color inside? You're never going to see that. So that's just my thoughts and feelings. However, another thing about this leather, it's very floppy. Well, I guess not very floppy because it's thick, but I mean, you can roll it and, you know, you won't get those wrinkles like you do with the Mr. Darcy. With this guy, if you roll it or, you know, scratch it, whatever, it'll come out pretty easily. So it does get a little bit of wear, but not the same as the Darcy leather does. So that is the Creme leather. And, you know, they're all gonna, most of them are the same. I have the Creme in the Creme Brulee color, which is more similar to like this color. It was a little bit more of a deeper brown than that, but it was lighter than this chocolate here. And it was the same way as this guy, which I'm super happy about because they were out of the Creme Brulee color. So I had to order the chocolate color, but I like the chocolate color better than the Creme Brulee color. So that's kind of funny how that worked out. The next leather I'll show you all is the Darcy leather. This is from a buy-sell trade group. Oh, and if I didn't mention, I bought this brand new from Chic Sparrow. So this is from a buy-sell trade group. I got it with the riveted pen loop, and this is the first classic I ever bought. And I wasn't super sure about it at first. It felt really plain to me, but the more I used it, the more I just loved it. I love just, you know, focusing on the leather and the way it looks. And then this is also the first riveted pen loop that I had, and I also fell in love with that as well, which, if you don't have one, I definitely recommend trying it. A lot of people prefer it over the stitched pen loop because of, it just is out of the way more than the stitched one is. With the Darcy, it is a sturdy leather, however, it's very sensitive, similar to its namesake, Mr. Darcy, from, what is that? Oh, I can't remember which Jane Austen novel it is, but it's from one of those. This leather is not nearly as thick as the Creme. It is still thick, but not as thick. It gets scratches extremely easy. You know, if I just, I'll just demonstrate because I don't care, but if I just, I'll just show you this way. If I rub my nail on it, there's that mark there, and that is going to be there forever. And with, you know, like I said, with my Darcy, I don't care because I like the scratches and the wear that it gets. If you're looking for a leather, however, that is very durable and isn't going to scratch or stain very easily, Darcy is not for you because it will scratch, like, you know, even just touching it. Like, you just touch it and it gets a scratch. You breathe at it, scratch. Look at it, scratch. You know what I mean? So it's like, just be prepared for that when you buy it. I love it, but some people don't. So, and if you've heard anything about Mr. Darcy from Chic Sparrow, then you have heard that. The inside has this more rough texture compared with the Creme, where it has this really soft suede. This is more of a rough feeling. I'll hold it up to the camera. I don't know if you can hear that, but let me see if we'll do the Creme. I mean, you can hear the difference. I can, at least. I don't know if you can. So that's something to keep in mind as well. For me, a person who is very sensitive to textures and feelings, like things like chalkboards, terracotta pots, what's the other one that gets me? There's something else. Anyway, things like that, they just give me the chills and the heebie-jeebies, and I just hate it. So even for me, a person that's, oh, it was cheap watercolor paints, that's what it was. They have that same chalky feeling. All of those things, I can't stand the feeling. But even for me, someone that's very sensitive to that, this roughness inside doesn't bother me all that much. I mean, obviously, I'd prefer it to be softer, but the roughness isn't like a deal breaker or anything, because I love how it gets those markings. So it's, you know, worth it to me in the end. And then the last leather that I've got, as I mentioned before, is the Outlander. Now, this I purchased from a second chance sale, so it's only a guess that it is an Outlander leather. And Jennifer Harvey, if you're watching this, you could leave a comment below confirming whatever it happens to be, if you know. I did leave a comment in the Chic Sparrow group though about it, and everyone has agreed with me that it is Outlander because of the floppiness of it and the thin, how thin it is, and also the coloring. They have told me that it is Sojourn Tan because of the color and the texture. Even though it has that reddish color, the texture is what everyone keeps telling me that makes it the Sojourn Tan and not the Jitney Red, because the Jitney Red has a different texture. As I said, this was a second chance sale purchase, so I got it for like $30, and so it's not, you know, 100%, I'm not 100% sure. This leather is a more rustic leather from, you know, from my experience with this guy. It has this really beautiful texturing where it goes from this more pebbled texture to down to a very smooth leather here, which I really love. It reminds me of a speckled fawns that I own that has, you know, the same texture where it's pebbled and then it runs into a very smooth texture, and I really love that. The speckled fawns has it's a Kodiak, it's a rustic Kodiak, and so it has a pocket on the front, on the inside, and three on the back, so it's super thick. But I love my Chic Sparrow leathers much more than my speckled fawns, besides the fact that Chic Sparrow's customer service is like top notch and speckled fawns is like eh. I've seen her kind of, anyways, not gonna get into that. This is a comparison video, not about drama. So yes, the leather is very thin and floppy and has a beautiful texture. Something else is that you can also roll this leather, and it's just like that. I could like scrunch it, and it's no big deal. This coloring is going to go away over time. Even just rubbing it, you know, it'll go away. You can see as I rub that it is, I mean, I hope you can see, it goes away really easily. I mean, I did this corner down here and it's already gone. Scratches will rub out fairly easily, so it's a pretty durable leather. Even if it does get some wear and tear, it will, I mean, from my experience, it should come out okay. Unless you obviously, like, you know, really scratch it, that may stay. You know, I haven't done that because, I mean, who does that? But, I mean, accidents happen. So, if that's something you're worried about, it may come out. Like I said, I haven't done that deep of a scratch before, but a lot of the minor things, minor dings that, you know, say Mr. Darcy picks up with all of his sensitivity, the Outlander isn't going to hold on to that the same way that the Darcy will. On the inside, it's this very soft, soft suede. It's even softer than the Creme leather. Here's a Creme for comparison. And because of its thinness as well, that makes it a little bit softer, but I mean, this is just like, this is just super, super soft. They're very similar, but this is just a touch more suede-like. So, there's that as well. If you're looking for a book that has structure and will, you know, hold your notebooks very sturdy, the Outlander may not be what you're looking for. I mean, this will wrap around your notebooks really, really well because of the thinness of the leather. It's going to just mold right to them. So if you like that way that that looks, the Outlander is great. but I personally prefer more structure to my notebook. So that's why I moved into that new Creme I bought. And if I had the option, I would have gotten a pen loop on here as well, the riveted one. But the only options you could choose were your style, deluxe or classic, and then your size, like, you know, pocket, personal, standard, things like that. So yeah, that is all of the leathers that I've got for you to compare. I honestly love all of them differently for different reasons. I have to say the Creme is my favorite just because I love the softness and the structure of it. Before I finish, I was wrapping up and then I remembered something I want to do for you guys is a thickness comparison very quickly, if I can get these all to be right next to each other so that you can see the thickness, right, you know, one after the other. So here we have Creme is here, then we have Darcy and Outlander. So you can see the difference in the thickness there, if it would focus on it. I don't know how to get it to, I think it's doing pretty good. I mean, you can tell how thick it is. The Creme is definitely much thicker than the other two. The Darcy and Outlander are very similar, but I think the way that, you know, the Darcy is a touch thicker and treated differently than the Outlander, so it's going to obviously be a different thickness slash structure there. So, like I said, or was trying to say, I am obsessed with Chic Sparrow. Everything that they put out is just amazing. Their quality is amazing. Their leather is amazing. I mean, even the Darcy is still soft. And I did have a Foxy Fix, I can't remember what leather it was. It was similar to the Creme. However, the Creme was much softer and just better. And I just love Jennifer. I love how, you know, how great the quality on their products. You know, they burnish their edges. The stitching is always set into like a little groove in the notebook, which I really like. And the thickness of the stitching is just better. Even though I personally don't prefer stitching, if I was going to have a notebook that was stitched, I prefer the Chic Sparrow stitching over the Foxy Fix because it's just much thicker than the Foxy Fix. That's just my opinion. You know, everyone loves different things for different reasons. Foxy Fix is much more customizable. but that's not something that I'm really concerned with. So anyway, there's my little Chic Sparrow comparison for you. You can leave a comment in the comment section below, and I will try to answer them as best as I can. If you have any questions about these leathers or what I've got, you know, every leather is going to be different no matter what, just because they're all handmade and, you know, they're just different. You know, they may be a whole different hide, so it's going to have a different texture or maybe a slightly different color. You will get variations like that. These are just what mine look like, and there's no guarantee yours will be the same. So just so you know, like this video, subscribe to my channel. I put out new planning videos as often as I can. I bullet journal as well, and I also have an Instagram, Happy Planaholic, on there too. I post like on that more than 3 times a week. I mean, I love putting my pictures up there. So yeah, I will see you guys next time. Thank you so much.